Now we know as we can go back in the prophetic line and we can go into at another point all the discussions about the head of gold, the arm and the chest of silver, the belly and the hip area of bronze, the feet that went down with iron and declared all of that in the image. And all the nations that will come up and go down, come up and go down. And what is to come when the great wrath of Christ Jesus come out and destroy all, hallelujah, and fill the earth. A time will come. But for the moment here, Daniel must proceed and be an epistle, a faithful one to the Almighty God, even in his place of test and trial. Daniel, she, and before that, the king had said, anyone who can tell and interpret, he will give them robe of purple, and he will give them gifts, and he will promote them. Hallelujah. When Daniel came to the part and revealed it to him, sowing the seed, the king had to say, Daniel's God is the God. Daniel's God is the revealer of secrets. Daniel's God reveals secrets. Then he said, look at the promotion inside of the place of test and trial. Nebuchadnezzar said, Daniel, I am giving you the power to be ruler over the province of Babylon. Over the province of Babylon, you are snatched from your land. You are placed into captivity. Weapons form against you left and right, right in your land of captivity. But in this very place, there is a promotion if we remain faithful to the Almighty God. Amen. And he was promoted to be ruler over the province of the kingdom, the Babylonian kingdom. And look what Daniel did. Daniel did this. He didn't say, I've made it. And never mind my brother and sister that walked with me when we first came. He didn't say, I made it. And never mind those who poured their life into me, who taught me about the word. Because Daniel and Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego, they were taught of the word. Because that was a custom. That was a custom to teach the commandments of God to the children. Daniel stretched out to the king and appealed to the king. And the king granted that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego would be rulers over the province in Babylon. Now he gave the power to Daniel, but Daniel shared power. And instead, Daniel sat at the king's, the gates of the king's court. He sat in the king's court, that's what the Bible said. But now, look at this. These three boys are now officials in the land of captivity. They're now overseeing other nations who were brought into captivity and now in Babylon. Because the custom at the time, when they took the people, they also allowed at times for them to keep their language and for them to worship their gods. And for that, in the such doing, they kind of kept some peace. But now this Daniel Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is over the kingdom. And here comes another thing. There's a test coming. There's a test coming. There's a golden image that's being created. 90 cubit feet. Cubit. It's coming. It's a huge image. And the decree will go forth to all the officials and the governors and the satraps and the administrators to go forth to declare to all the nations that they oversee, this image must be worshipped. The king Nebuchadnezzar called for all his officials. Who were among the officials? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And they had to come before the king, along with the others, and hear the decree, and bow down when they hear this lyre and the different musical instruments. Bow down and worship this golden image. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, in authority and position, had power in the land. Seemingly, they made it. But there came a place in their circumstance at that very moment that they had to make a decision. Be thou glorified in this, Father. Get some fruit out of this, Father. Or submit to the flesh and stand with the earthly treasure and reject and deny the Almighty God.
I'm delivering you.
them that will come from his hand. Many are the afflictions of the righteous according to Psalm 34. But, hallelujah, the Lord delivers them all from them all. Hallelujah. And then he said, but just in case, if our God, who we serve, does not, if he doesn't choose to, if he doesn't deliver us, let it be known. I loved you when I read that. Let it be known. Let it be published throughout your kingdom. King, hear us. And hear us clearly in essence. Hear us. We still not going to bow to the image. We're not going to serve your God. We refuse. Now remember, I said that the king was looking at them, you know, just as in, oh, this is just a matter of a moment before they come to their senses. He had ridiculed them. He had already said, who can deliver you out of my hands? He already said that. And then the word said, after they said that, the word said the king's countenance changed toward them. His anger, his fury, the wrath, because here these three captives think they're so big they could defy the king in his glorious estate before all the other administrators and satraps and governors. He got so heated, and the enemy gets very heated when we in our position, seated high, looking down in our circumstances with the perspective of God, with the perspective and the mindset of Jesus Christ, can defy the very thing, the very evidence that something is going against us, can stand up against us. So he said, hit the furnace 7 times hot. He said, go get the strongest men in my army. He was expecting the Hebrew boys to wrestle and tussle. He was expecting the Hebrew boys to get nervous as the time came. Yeah, they have a lot of mouth. Yeah, they can say all that. But when they're coming and they're going to be taken in, they're going to be resisting. They're not going to be saying, our God can deliver us. So he said, send the strong ones. Send the strong men. And they came.
Glorify
me. Hallelujah. And God loved to display himself. God loved to take the opportunity to display his glory. Hallelujah. Yes, Sister Brown. The boys weren't going to resist. They were already confident. They were already convicted of the God that they serve. They were already ready to give up their life. They were already ready to sacrifice themselves. That their God will be glorified and men may see and glorify God. That the mission that they were given as the children of Israel when they came out of the wilderness to present themselves as light to the surrounding nations, that all nations would worship God. They were willing to hold forth the covenant of promise that they will be God's people and God will be their God.
Amen.
And when he came to that place, they threw him in. And the Bible said the men who put them in, they were killed, consumed. Because the hot, the fiery furnace was so intense. And because